in search also of the devil by mine. Grasping at his confusion, he had the disorienting sense of knowing who he was, but felt that he was perhaps someone else. He realized that he was astride a horse of some kind. This was not a normal horse. Its movements and sounds were weird and almost mechanical, with hard and jerky drops and rises. There was no sound, and his legs were pulled against the side of this pseudo-beast. Even its breathing seemed somehow chopped up into erratic cycles of snorts and squeals. He found himself hypnotized by the folds of sound and movement, unable to focus on his surroundings as they journeyed further along an unknown course in the dark. It seemed that they had ascended a hill which was crowded by a thicket of dead trees. A golden light shone through their tangle like a frame of black rays, which formed an ominous arch of the path ahead. The beast lay sealed, and he was able to look down at either side of the path, which was littered all around with acorns, rotted apples, and the remains of half-eaten fish carcasses. He was disgusted at the waste of the tree, and wondered who could have been responsible for it. The heavy hooves crushed the bones and acorns, plodding on toward the unknown. Exiting the group of dead trees, he found himself descending. Looking down at the craggy hilltop, he saw the most identical view straight down below. The water played day waves of the golden light, and he felt drawn to approach it. As he neared, he started lots of movements in the rushes on his screen's main name. A woman known now, working in the water with some light cloth. She seemed oblivious to be standing to his side. She stretched the wet cloth out, and he could see that it was a shirt with a long, red stain across it. Somehow he knew that this was his shirt.